Hey guys, this is Kevin Murphy on my channel called Narcissistic Abuse, Learning Who I Am Again. This is going to be a quick video on the characteristics of the narcissistic momster slash matriarch. So the narcissistic mother in herself is very, very selfish. She normally has children just out of her own need to feel loved, out of her own need to dictate and to control and to be in charge. A lot of people, not a whole lot of people have narcissistic mothers. I myself didn't have a narcissistic mother, but I know the characteristics of what a narcissistic mother, how these women operate. And there's two different kinds of narcissistic mothers. There's the enmeshing kind of narcissistic mother, the one who's incredibly intrusive, very involved in all of your day-to-day business, constantly calling you, to keeping tabs on you and things like that. Very, very controlling, very, very just in your face. And then you have the ignoring narcissistic mother who's very neglectful. She really doesn't care about her kids. I mean, neither one of the narcissistic mothers, types of narcissistic mothers, really necessarily care about their children, but the enmeshing narcissistic mother kind of fakes the funk a little bit, whereas the ignoring narcissistic mother just doesn't give a damn. But I want to talk a little bit about the enmeshing narcissistic mother first. The the qualities of an enmeshing narcissistic mother is someone who, she's the one that she tries to triangulate. She is the one that she has to be centerfold. So she's going to be the mom that's always in, who's the cool mom. She's the one that's going to know all your friends. She's going to be the mom that will probably do certain things with your friends. If you drink, she'll probably drink with you and your friends. If you go shopping and all the time, clothes shopping or whatever with your friends, she will tag along with your friends too. You're not allowed to have your own identity apart from that enmeshing narcissistic mother. You're pretty much an extension of her, or she is an extension of you. You and her are so close together, you don't know where you begin and she doesn't know where you end, or whatever that phrase is. But it's very, very toxic, because as a teenager and as a child, and as a mom, as the mother, you are supposed to work on ways to let your offspring go. Like, your mom is not supposed to be your everything all of your life. And there's going to be different degrees of need that you're going to have for your mom, because that's your mother and she's someone who gave birth to you. But these narcissistic mothers take it to a whole new level, and it's very, very, very weird. The ignoring narcissistic mother is more, she would be more neglectful. She's the kind of mother that won't go to your parent-teacher conferences. She's the kind of mother that, will leave you to make your own dinners when you get home from school. She's the kind of mother that is really hands-off. She's not into, she doesn't care about your grade. She doesn't care about your friends. She doesn't care about what your favorite color is. She doesn't care about what your favorite dinner is. She's very cold. She's very neglectful. She's very disengaged with her child. That's the ignoring narcissistic mother. But what both of these women have in common are the lack of empathy and the lack of boundaries and the selfishness that they carry. And these moms, they just don't, they, you know, like, The ignoring narcissistic mother is very, you know, she feels inconvenience being a mom. She feels that the child's needs are an inconvenience for her. So that child is left to feel very neglectful. A lot of these kids who are raised by a narcissistic, ignoring narcissistic mother, they usually act out. They usually are very, very temperamental. They're usually very bad. Or they become bullies themselves because they're not getting the nurture and the care and the compassion from that mom. And narcissistic mothers in general lack the ability to be nurturing. They lack the ability to be caring like a normal functioning mother would be. So the narcissistic mother also has the ability to create total chaos. She is a one-woman tornado. She's a one-woman bomb show. She tends to create strife when, you know, and in my upcoming videos, I'll talk about triangulation and how the narcissist will try to use gossip to triangulate or to try to turn other people against you out of concern or venting or things like that. So that's the smear campaign and the triangulation, and I'll talk about that in my next video. But the narcissistic mother and triangulation is very, very, very lethal. And she uses, you know, her, you know, a narcissistic mother may have two or three children, and those two or three children are like casualties. A lot of these kids will grow up not being close to one another. They will grow up feeling a sense of loss. They'll go and they'll see their other friends have very close relationships with their brother and sister, and they'll yearn for that love and that appreciation for their brother, that sibling or whatever. These siblings normally grow up hating each other because the narcissistic mother will say, "Hey, Susan, guess what Johnny said about you? Johnny said that Johnny said that your head is big." And then that's, you know, Susan's pissed off because of the fact that this narcissistic mother is telling them crap about what their sibling has said. That is what they do. And that is not done out of concern. It's not done out of, you know, out of love or anything like that. That's to keep the narcissistic mother in the centerfold of the family, the centerfold of the drama, the centerfold of the gossip. And another example is, you know, the mom could be on the phone calling, you know, Susan and saying that, you know, Johnny has been hospitalized because he had a nervous breakdown. And the mom will be sitting there, you know, covertly gossiping about Johnny's condition, saying, you know, "I always knew that he was kind of off, and I always knew that he needed my assistance," and things like that, you know. And Johnny could be the scapegoat child. Johnny could be the only person that is standing up to the narcissist. But because the narcissist is a coward and the narcissist hates defeat and hates anybody that goes against her, she will sit there and say things about Johnny to make other people in the family think that he's crazy and to keep them away from him. And so she'll do it in ways like, "Susan, you know, Johnny is hasn't been himself, and he talks to me any kind of way, and he's really nasty, and he's really disrespectful to me, and he they'll even embellish and exaggerate things too. Yeah, he even threw a book at me, and he even you know, dropped a few F-bombs and things like that." And this is what they do to isolate the person who's trying to stand up for themselves. And that is a form of triangulation. That is a form of narcissistic emotional abuse. So, it seems like I'm getting a call. So anyway, This is a quick video on characteristics of how the narcissistic mother is. Please stay tuned for new videos that are coming up. And please subscribe to my channel, Kevin Murphy, Narcissistic Abuse, Learning Who I Am Again. And I promise to have more videos coming up. I just have to make this one a little short because it's been a long day at work and I'm ready to cook and call it a night. So look for another video tomorrow on part two of Characteristics of the Narcissistic Mother. And I hope to see you soon. Take care. Bye.